Hello again. I called earlier, but how long will you take, ma'am?
I thought I told you I would settle this nonsense tomorrow.
I understand. In that case, I'll call the police.
That would only cost, what, $200-$300?
It's about 1.2 acres of vandalism, ma'am, so it'll amount to $30,000.
What?
Trouble busters!
All right, I've arrived. I think it was somewhere around here. I'm sure it was here. Ah, jackpot! So I really kept it here after all. Thank goodness. Hold up, is anyone there?
Oh shit.
Hold it right there!
Damn it, man!
Don't you run away from me! What the hell do you think you're doing this late at night?
What? What did you do? Nothing. I only did all that because I wanted to.
What the devil? Lend me your cell phone.
Huh? Why?
Not important. Just give it to me. Do you want me to call the police instead?
The police?
Call your parents. Now.
Oh, sure.
What do you want?
Mom, listen.
Let me talk to her. Hello, ma'am? Are you the boy's mother?
Huh? And who are you?
My name is Alan Thompson. But more importantly, your son has just vandalized my private storage chamber.
What time do you think it frickin' is, Alan? I'll make amends tomorrow. Hell, I'll even pay you the damages.
Huh? I currently own a house, but I recently started renovating it. That was why I was thinking about what to do with my belongings. I was introduced to a certain landlord by my real estate.
Hello, is this the number of one, Mr. Alan Thompson?
Yes, Alan Thompson speaking.
My name is Clifford Jones, introduced to you by Tiger Cat Real Estate.
Ah, you're the owner of Chambers Aligned. Yes, Tiger Cat has informed me of you. Thank you very much for calling me.
No trouble at all, sir. Now, if you'll excuse me, let's get down to business about a chamber.
Ah, of course. Yes. How much will it cost?
Just for this time, the cost will be zilch, sir.
Excuse me?
I heard from Tiger Cat that you are at a young age, happily married and raising a newborn daughter, and are working very hard to build a home and a happy family. Quite the impression you've made, Mr. Thompson.
Huh? Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Jones.
It's no secret that I want to support such aspiring people. The space I'm lending out this time is not actually in use at all, so feel free to use it however you please.
My word, this is wonderful news! Thank you, sir! I don't have many resources to spare, so this is a huge help!
I was like that once upon a time when I was young, and I know how you feel.
Thank you so much! Well, I'll take your word for it then. The company in charge was very kind and they let my family borrow it for free, however and whenever we pleased. I thought such a kindness would never come again, and I was sure it would be smooth from here on out. Until one day, when I went to check on the house being renovated. It's going pretty well, it seems. We'll definitely move back in on schedule.
Huh, so annoying. This house is a huge nuisance.
Pardon me, ma'am. Was the construction noise too much for you?
It's rather the presence of construction work that is the real nuisance.
Excuse me?
Why in the world would you go about making reformations when you're still so young?
I don't believe you have any right to complain about that particular aspect, ma'am. More to the point, what is with your attitude these past few moments? Rather mannerless, I must say.
The hell you just say to me? It's that sort of stupid cockiness that gets me so angry.
And likewise, ma'am.
How dare you little... I've had enough! Apologize to me now!
And why must I?
You're sure you're all right with disrespecting me like that? I don't care what will happen, you know?
Is that a threat?
Just you wait and see.
Apparently, the woman mistakenly assumed that I was showing off my wealth because I was renovating my home. It was simply a matter of repairing the foundation and structure that had been distorted by a recent earthquake, but it didn't seem like I would get her to understand, so I just dropped the subject. How could I have known that this story would take a turn towards a tremendous incident? I shall return to the present after I had just caught a college student red-handed. Hello, ma'am? Are you this boy's mother?
Huh? And who are you?
My name is Alan Thompson, but more importantly, your son has just vandalized my private storage chamber.
What time do you think it frickin' is, Alan? I'll make amends tomorrow. Hell, I'll even pay you damages.
Huh? This voice sounds familiar. Excuse me, could we have met within the past week?
And what does that have to do with anything? That doesn't concern this.
In any case, there's something I'd like to talk about, so could you please come immediately?
I'm telling you.
If you refuse to come, I shall contact the police.
The police? I understand, I'll be right over.
All that said, I ended the call. I didn't expect the woman to be that same bitch I met the other day, and instead of showing any remorse, it sounded like she was thinking all this a nuisance. But in any case, what a coincidence. While I was thinking about this and that, the owner of the storage room, Mr. Jones, heard a commotion and rushed over.
What's happened, Mr. Thompson?
Oh, Mr. Jones, actually... All I did was step out of his way. He looked like he was struck by lightning when he saw the vandalism before him. Although he lent it to me with very good intentions, I felt as if I had trampled on his trust in me, and I felt very sorry about the matter.
How did this come about?
This young man did it, sir.
Why did you do this?
I asked his mother to come over now. However, since it's unlikely to come to any good conclusions, I'd call the police depending on the situation.
Am I going to get arrested?
I guess so, bud. Even though you're still a college student, you did something you shouldn't have done. There's a possibility.
No, please, I was...
Speak up, buddy. Then the student started talking about the matter. And I was quite surprised to hear the facts, and... So that's what happened, eh? Thanks, buddy. That helped. Leave the rest to us.
Huh?
Mr. Thompson, actually...
The landlord of the chamber, Mr. Jones, who had also heard the details from the university student, suggested a certain idea to me. I eventually thought that I might have to do something like that anyhow, so I decided to go through with it. Unforgivable! Troublebusters, initiate! However, no matter how much we waited, the woman never came. It shouldn't take more than 10 minutes to get to this place. I called her again. Hello again. I called earlier, but how long will you take, ma'am?
I thought I told you we would settle this nonsense tomorrow.
I understand. In that case, I'll call the police.
I was just thinking about that, by the way. There's no way the police would act on a matter where simply paying the cost of vandalism should suffice.
I don't think the cost matters. And also, you seem to be misunderstanding an important detail. How much do you think it will cost exactly?
It would only cost, what, $200-$300?
It's about 1.2 acres of vandalism, ma'am, so it'll amount to $30,000.
What? Wait a minute, I'll come right away.
With that being said, I hung up. 10 minutes later, the woman came.
The hell you mean, 1.2 acres? You goddamn liar! $200-$300 should be enough to fix something like this.
I agree. If only it was just this chamber that was vandalized.
Huh?
Let me explain from here.
Who the hell are you?
I am but a humble man who manages this chamber, ma'am.
Oh, is that so?
As for the cost of these repairs, as Mr. Thompson here mentioned earlier, it is expected to be around $30,000.
That's ridiculous! What is with this preposterous amount? And what does this 1.2 acres mean, eh?
All the land you see before you is managed by myself, ma'am. That land amounts to approximately 1.2 acres.
I'm telling you, it doesn't matter! This time my son only scribbled on this trunk room, didn't he? All you have to do is fix this!
We would love to do that too.
Then do it for Christ's sakes!
But the government says that is just no good.
What? The government?
Yes indeed, ma'am. We were instructed that the buildings in this area have the same color you see.
The frick does that do to help anything?
This is to protect the cityscape. Therefore, when changing the color of a building, it is absolutely necessary to change the entire surrounding area.
What the? I've never heard of such stupidity!
But this is the contract signed with the government.
With that said, Mr. Jones showed the woman the contract he had signed with the government to protect the cityscape. The woman, whose name turned to be Mr. Dahlia Kingman, with her son called Darren, was skeptical at first. But as she read through the document, her face turned pale as she realized that what he was saying was true.
Wait a minute! I know what this is all about now, but that doesn't mean it's obligatory to paint everything another color. I think you should just repaint the chamber, see?
Regrettably, the company that used to make the paint for these chambers went bankrupt mere weeks ago. Therefore, I will never be able to get the exact same paint again.
But that shouldn't...
And that's why the only alternative is to paint everything with what your son used.
This is so stupid!
Well, you may think so, ma'am, but since that is stated in the contract, it can't be helped.
That doesn't matter to us.
Well, it certainly shouldn't matter.
I knew it!
However...
Yes?
Since it was your family that vandalized the chamber, you are responsible for fixing it.
Like hell that's true!
No. Since your son did it, Mrs. Kingman, you as his parent have a responsibility as well.
Darren!
What?
Why did you do this? You're a good adult too, so you should take responsibility.
No way! You...
No excuses! Are you insane for doing something like this?
Actually, I thought that was very strange too, you see.
Eh?
I wonder if Darren here, a college student, would do such a stupid thing.
There's something like that about this boy, you see. I'll make him pay for the rest. Now that everything's settled, I'll be heading home.
Yes, ma'am.
Well then.
If you weren't involved in this incident.
What? But it was Darren that did it all.
The real question is why Darren did it, Mrs. Kingman.
Huh?
Well, if he did it out of nothing but youthful impulse, I think he should take responsibility and pay, as you think so too.
Well then...
But if he was forced to do it under threats from another party, it would be a whole new ball game.
What?
Darren, buddy, what do you think?
Darren, you understand, right?
Mrs. Kingman, could you please be quiet for a moment?
How dare... I'm Darren's mother, Thompson. You have no right or authority to tell me to shut up.
Well now, that is strange, isn't it? When it comes to taking responsibility for Darren's misconduct this time, you cower away your rightful responsibilities as his parent. And what do when he's about to tell the truth? You suddenly sacrifice your dignity. That's quite unfair, to be frank.
What?
Darren, buddy, no one's gonna hurt you. Please, the truth.
Mom told me to do it.
Darren!
And so it seems, Mrs. Kingman. What does he mean, ma'am?
I don't know. So ashamed of him, lying his way to escape in this hopelessness.
Is it a lie, Darren?
Well...
Darren, you better be responsible here. Don't cause any more trouble to people.
And why don't you just stop threatening him for once?
It's not a lie. I didn't want to do it at all. But you told me that if I didn't, you wouldn't contribute to paying for school.
You...
I see. And what say you to all this, ma'am?
Shit!
But Darren, even if what you say is true, you mustn't do anything you shouldn't do. So I'll hold you partially responsible for this, all right?
Yes, sir.
That's right, even if I told you to, you were the one who did it, Darren. I don't have any responsibility.
So, you admit you instructed him to do it?
Well, even if I admit it, I can't be held responsible for hearsay. I admit it. Are we done now? I'm going home, so you do what you want.
And just like that, the cat's out of the bag.
Huh?
It is true that Darren is the direct perpetrator here. He's a college student and a fully functioning adult.
So it doesn't matter to me.
When it comes to being responsible as an adult's parent, no, it doesn't.
What?
But you are involved in this matter, are you not?
But I was at home and everything was done by Darren.
Giving instructions to someone else for doing something illegal is a crime in and of itself, you know.
No, what? That's...
Darren made his claim, and you also clearly admitted to giving him instructions to vandalize my chamber.
No, listen.
This is a seriously criminal act, Mrs. Kingman. So you have to take responsibility too.
A crime? Come on now, that's a bit of an exaggeration.
No exaggeration, ma'am. As a matter of fact, the total damage amounts to $30,000.
But that money is just because you signed a contract with the government without me knowing anything.
That is true. But I also don't think this would have happened if you hadn't given instructions to Darren.
No, well...
Is there anything else you would like to say?
I meant it's a joke, Mr. Thompson.
A joke?
Of course a joke. It's just that Darren went berserk and actually did the damn crime.
What the... That's not...
I see. Played the ace in your pocket, eh? And by the way, what exactly did you say to Darren? Darren, what were you told?
Darren!
It's all right, buddy. We understand the general flow, so feel free to say it in your own words.
Mom told me all the specific details of what she wanted me to do.
And I'm telling you, I was kidding.
The chamber had all your furniture stored away, she said. They're pissing me off, so go give them a taste of their own medicine, she said.
You little...
Well, of course I said I didn't want to. Then, as I mentioned earlier, I was told that she wouldn't pay for my university expenses, and...
I see. That must have been tough.
All lies! How far do you have to lie to be satisfied?
They're not all lies! I'm telling the truth, sir!
Everyone, don't be fooled by this boy. I feel sorry for raising a child in this manner.
Your words are contradicting.
Mine are telling only the truth.
So let's do this.
Do what?
Let's call the police and have them investigate.
What?
That's a different story. You said you would call the police if I didn't come.
Please call them. I feel like I have to take responsibility too.
That's awesome, buddy. I'm glad you understand. However, you may have misunderstood a little.
Huh?
The police won't be coming just for this particular incident with the chamber, you know.
What?
It's to protect you and your younger brother, Darren.
I'm so lost. What do you mean?
Before you came, Mrs. Kingman, I asked Darren about his family environment.
There's nothing wrong with our environment.
It seems like you hardly ever go home, do you?
What? How?
You seem to be off gallivanting every night.
That has nothing to do with you.
It doesn't matter to me, sure.
Then Don't freaking say things that you don't even understand. Isn't it batshit insane to just take what Darren says at face value?
That's why I'm asking the police to investigate.
What?
If what Darren is saying is true, it's a very big deal. On the other hand, if it's not true, then there's nothing to be worried about.
No.
I'm merely calling the police and have them investigate. Even you are confident that what Darren says is wrong, are you not?
Well...
If that's the case, wouldn't it be better to call the police and have them settle the matter once and for all?
But it's the police!
Is it inconvenient to you in some way?
No, not exactly.
Then it should be alright.
But wait a minute. I'll pay for all the living expenses.
Hmm?
I would just like him to be grateful for that alone, and he really has no right to say something like this.
If Darren's story is true, you're only giving him money then.
That alone is enough, because you can't live without money.
But wouldn't that be a problem all on its own?
Huh?
After all, the only thing you could do as his parent was give him money. And yet you still threatened to cut him off completely.
What are you talking about?
This is about the chamber, Mrs. Kingman.
What?
You threatened to cut off your support to Darren if he didn't carry out the vandalism on the chamber.
I'm telling you, it was a joke!
No. From his point of view, ma'am, if a child was told that their parents were cutting them off financially, which is the only job they do as a parent, they won't ever think it's a joke.
But Darren just did it on his own!
It doesn't make sense now, does it? That's why I'm offering to call the police.
Wait a minute, please! Not the police!
Too late, ma'am. If you had dealt with the chamber issue in good faith and sincerity, I wouldn't have taken this course of action.
I'm so sorry for that, truly.
It's still too late, ma'am. Took you damn near an eternity to get here, didn't it? During that time, I asked Darren a lot of things. And at first, I thought that such a thing would be impossible in this age.
No, please.
But your non-existent attitude of remorse and your threatening attitude towards Darren, once I saw those, I started to think that it was all true.
I tell you, sir, it's not what you think.
However, since there are contradicting opinions here, I think it would be better to have a third party investigate the matter thoroughly.
Please no, not the police.
You really don't like the police, eh? Funny.
Well, you see, yes.
Darren?
Yes, sir?
Your mother's saying all this, but what do you think we should do?
I feel...
Darren, darling, Mummy's so sorry for what happened. I'll change from now on, I swear.
Which means you will be taking full responsibility for this chamber issue, right?
What? That means?
That means that you will pay 30 grand, right?
But that's Darren's responsibility.
Then you haven't changed at all, have you?
You're always like this, Mom. You always claimed you'd change when things got bad, but once it all subsided, you went back to your old grumpy self.
No, I'm for real. This time, please, I'll change. Oh, I know. I'll contribute some to the 30 grand myself, so let's pay the money together.
Darren, buddy, this ain't it.
Mr. Thompson, please call the police.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir. I'll work and pay back all the money I owe you for the storage room.
Got it. Let's talk about the details later on.
Thank you so much, Mr. Thompson. Please call the police.
Hey, Darren.
Shut up. I've had enough. It's time for you to take a hard look at what you've done all these years, Mom.
So it seems, Mrs. Kingman. Calling them now.
Please, no. Anything but that.
I immediately contacted the police. When I explained the situation, Mrs. Kingman was taken into custody. Later, after interrogations, she was identified as the main culprit in the crime. As for Darren, while he wasn't completely innocent, considering the circumstances and his genuine remorse for his actions, he was only given a strict warning. What happened after that was that Mrs. Kingman was charged with the full amount for the chamber. The repairs were completed quickly, and Mr. Jones was so happy to forgive me after how the situation improved. Trouble busters!